I'm Eric Wilson with Keysight Technologies. Today I will show you how to access the FPGA in one of our arbitrary waveform generator or digitizer modules so that you can customize the module for your specific application. Here is a Keysight PXI chassis with 18 slots. The first slot contains the chassis controller, and our programmable FPGA module is in slots 4 and 5. In the following tutorial, we will be using the graphical programming environment PathWave FPGA, which runs on your laptop or desktop PC, to configure the FPGA in the module.
In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to create a PathWave FPGA project for the M3202A BSP. To get started, launch PathWave FPGA from the Start menu and select File, New Hardware Project. The new project wizard will show, and you will be presented with the project name tab. You can enter a project name or project location. I will be using the default project name and project location for this example. Click the next button and you will see the project type, where you can select the board support package. I will be using the M3202A BSP for this example. Click next and you will see project options for the selected BSP. I will be using the M3202A 4-channel variable clock K41 FPGA module. Click next and you will see the project template options, where you can choose a default or blank project template. The default project template becomes pre-populated with BSP IP blocks that you can use with the Keysight SD1 software panel. Or you can do a blank project template, which does not pre-populate the canvas with IP blocks, and you can add your own IP to the canvas. Click next and you'll see a project summary page of the options you previously selected from the pages. Click finish to create the design template. Once the template is created, you will see that the template has been pre-populated with IP blocks. The M3202A is an arbitrary waveform generator, and so it uses the function generator and mod gain blocks. The function generator and mod gain blocks are controlled by the sandbox I/O interfaces, function generator control and mod gain control, and these blocks are what the Keysight SD1 software panel uses to control the registers in the function generator and mod gain blocks. The PathWave FPGA also provides sandbox I/O that you can use in your design. You are able to use the input and outputs for the module, arbitrary waveform inputs, and the function generator and mod gain control blocks, along with PXI triggers and the front panel trigger connector. PathWave FPGA also comes with real-time HVI that you can use in your design, along with system interfaces like a clock and reset and some synchronization signals. PathWave FPGA also comes with IP repositories. You have the basic IP repository, which contains some simple IP blocks like a combiner or a delay or a latch. And you also have the BSP IP, which is the function generator and mod gain control, along with a DDR streamer block. You can also use connectors. We have an AXI4 light to MEM connector in case you need to connect your AXI4 interface up to a MEM interface. And we have some math IP blocks and some memory IP blocks that you can use in your design. Once you have created your design, you can hit the build FPGA bitfile button. This will bring up the FPGA hardware dialog, where you can select the implementation or the build type from synthesis, implementation, or implement from DCP. Implement from DCP allows you to select a pre-generated sandbox DCP file that you created outside of PathWave FPGA and use PathWave FPGA for the final implementation step. Once you have selected your build type, you can hit run and PathWave FPGA will generate a bit file.